Good morning, Calvary. I say good morning, Calvary. Yeah, that was cheap. Sorry about that. We ask you to rise and join us in praise. Rise as you are able. Stand with us. Come. Now is the time to worship. Come. Now is the time to give your heart. Come, just as you are to worship. Come, just as you are before your God. Come. One day every tongue will confess you are God. One day every knee will bow. Still the greatest treasure remains for those who gladly choose you now. Come, now is the time to worship. Now is the time to give your heart. Come, just as you are to worship. Come, just as you are before your God. Come. One day every tongue will confess you are God. One day every knee will bow. Still the greatest treasure remains for those who gladly choose you now. Willingly we choose to surrender lives. Willingly our knees will bow. With our hearts, soul, mind and strength, we gladly choose you now. Time to worship. Come, now is the time to give your heart. Come, just as you are to worship. Come, just as you are before.
Be seated. Welcome to worship. The world might call this Super Bowl Sunday, but here at Calvary, we call it Super Worship Sunday, as we combine all the elements of our morning worship services into one power-packed gathering. We look forward to hearing from the children and the youth and everyone in worship this morning, and welcome everyone, especially if you're a visitor here. This is our Unity Worship Service, one service today. Usually we worship at 7:45, 9:15, and 10:45. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
The second step.
Thank you.
Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who stretches out the heavens, who sends light to the nations, who gives breath to us all. Cherish the values of this world.
We cause others to stumble.
The earth is wounded by our excess.
Forgive us, renew us, and raise us upon eagle's wings, that we may do your will with courage and life.
You're the voice of heaven. You are my own, my beloved.
God is the tower to the weary.
Call forward our kindergartners and our first graders for the greeting. Together, let us pray. Lord God, with endless mercy, you receive the prayers of all who call upon you. By your Spirit, show us the things we ought to do, and give us the grace and power to do them. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. And the congregation may be seated as the Cherub and Junior Choirs sing. One of the ways we seek to be salt and light is partnering with an organization called Water to Thrive for the last 3 or 4 years. Dick Muller, the executive director, based out of Texas, I believe, but Dick travels around the world, and he'll share with you this morning an update of Water to Thrive and some of our partnering with them.
Thank you.
Welcome.
Good morning. Joyce and I are blessed to be here, part of your congregation this morning, and thank you so much for your support over the years. Water to Thrive was introduced to Calvary back in 2013 by Jim and Cora Scott, and since then, Jeff Heim has been our advocate here, and this congregation has done wonderful things to support our ministry. Just by way of background, we got started in 2008 in a Lutheran congregation in Austin, Texas, much like yours. Since then, through primarily congregations, but not totally, we have funded about 750 water projects in Tanzania and Uganda. Clean water for about 425,000 people. We are blessed to have your congregation as part of our work. I'm going to share with you a quick little video, and it'll tell you a lot about what we do and how we do it. I'm really happy and pleased that the youth of the congregation were able to be here this morning. I know that they've been very active in helping to provide funds for the projects that were funded by Calvary, so thanks very much for the opportunity for them to be able to participate in this. Over our history, the cost of helping people get clean water has averaged about $10 per person. Each water project costs about $5,000, and it lasts 20 years. With partners in each of those countries, and they do terrific work for us. Values very similar to ours, and help the communities develop structure to maintain the wells over a long period of time. Brad, you're going to have to advance it for me. Thanks. Maybe not. Okay, so what I have is a map that shows the six water projects that Calvary has funded and pictures of each of the locations. The first two were funded in, here we go. There's six water projects up in the top. You see the two dots are in Uganda, and down below there are actually four dots there. They're so close together, sort of sitting on top of each other, but in southern part of Tanzania, close to Iringa, and then two more in the northern part in the Maasai country. Okay, advance. These are your 2014 projects with the plaques from your communities, and they've been in service for a good portion of time. These six wells provide clean water for about 3,000 people that live within 6/10 of a mile of the water project. Next. These projects in Tanzania and Uganda are in progress. They're being developed, and they should be finished by the middle of this year, and I'll be sending Jeff completion pictures with community information. And Jeff also has the GPS coordinates of all of these projects if anyone is interested. Next. And these are the ones in Uganda. What's interesting about your projects is the first two were boreholes, the next two were hand-dug wells, and the final two are spring systems. So we work in three different technologies, and your wells are one, or each of them are in each of our three different technologies. Next. We have a lot of different ways that folks can participate with. Joyce and I will be out in the Welcome Center with brochures and be able to answer your questions. And we're just happy to be here, and thank you so much, and especially to the children for the support. You're helping tons of other children in these get access to clean water. Thank you.
So everyone saw the joy of the people who were pushing the lever and having water. So let's, in solidarity, put your arm up, and let's do in three times, we're going to pump it in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and just give thanks to God. Here we go. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. God, thank you for generosity. Make us grateful and generous people. Thank you for your ministry. Continue with hearing the word from our fifth grade class.
Well, it's game day, right? Yeah, some people are getting ready. Well, one of the things I love is the pre-game pep talk. So let's go to the disciples. Today is game day for them as well. You see, Jesus has been baptized and he spent 40 days in the wilderness being tempted by the devil. And when he comes out of the wilderness, he takes up John's mantle, which is fulfilling the prophecy. And he begins his public ministry. Well, right away, we heard last week in the Gospel of Matthew, Jesus calls the first of the disciples, Simon Peter, and his brother Andrew, James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John. The team is forming. Well, they traveled throughout Galilee, and Jesus is healing and teaching and proclaiming the good news. But then Jesus sees the crowds mounting. People from all over are coming to see him. Great multitudes from Galilee, from the Decapolis, from Jerusalem and Judea, and even beyond the Jordan. So what does Jesus do? He goes up the mountain and he sits down and his team huddles around him. And then, as any good coach would do before the game opening whistle, he gives them a pep talk. Relevant still to us today. So huddle up, huddle up. It's game time. And I know you're ready. You know how I know you're ready? Because I know you. I know you by name. I know your heart. And I have called you to this team. I know you, and I have made you ready. You are ready to bless the poor in spirit. You are ready to bless those who mourn and those who are meek. You are ready to bless the one who hungers and thirsts for righteousness. And you are ready to bless each other when you are the one who is reviled and persecuted because of me. You see, that's what this team is for. We care for each other, and together we care for those who can't care for themselves. Listen. I know you're afraid. There is so much to do. So much pain and suffering and injustice. So many people searching for hope and healing, meaning and salvation. The crowd down the mountain, it's big. But make no mistake, you are ready. I have made you ready. You are the salt of the earth. That means you are a part of God's great covenant. You are part of what God is doing through me right here in this time and in this place. And yes, because it is my time, it is your time. So don't let fear cause you to be trampled underfoot. That's what happens to salt that has lost its saltiness. I mean, it's good for nothing but to be discarded, sprinkled on the roadways, to be trampled under the feet of travelers. No, do not be afraid. Now is your time. I have called you to be the salt of the earth. And you are the light of the world. Your light will bring peace and comfort to those who are sitting in darkness. Your light will shine like a city on a hill. And you are ready. You are ready because I have lit the light that is in you with the salvation I bring. Oh, and you won't believe the things that you will accomplish in my name. You will heal with just a touch, a hug, a handshake, a smile. And you will cast out demons, lightening the lives of others with your friendship and by your care. You are the light of the world. Now is your time to sit up on that lampstand and bring light to all who are in the house. So let your light shine. Shine with love. Shine with patience. Shine with kindness. Shine so brightly that through those works of your hands, people will see that light and know that the kingdom of God is here. Rise up. Rise up and go. It's game time. Go do what you have been prepared to do. Be salt. Be light. You are ready. On three, go team. One, two, three, go team. Amen. Congregation, please stand for the reading of our prayers.
Gracious God, we thank you for the opportunity to worship freely and share our faith. We ask you to continue to provide us with opportunities to share our faith with those around us, trusting in you.
Yay, God.
We pray for all the many churches in our area. May we as Christians continue to find community and worship within the church. Help us to support the church to which we belong, trusting in you.
Yay, God.
We pray for our country and for a smooth transition of power in our government, trusting in you.
Yay, God.
We pray for the world and all who are experiencing war and violence. We pray for people living under constant danger around the world, that they may find safety, trusting in you.
Yay, God.
We pray for those who are sick and suffering, that you provide the needs of their hearts. We pray for all who are suffering physically or emotionally, that they may find healing in you. Please comfort those who mourn the loss of loved ones. Today, we especially pray for those silently or aloud.
We pray for comfort for all who are mourning the loss of loved ones. Especially, we pray for the family and friends of Betty Brown, Aubrey Cleland, Betsy Finney, Sam Ellis, Paul Moiser, Dorothy Myers, and William Smith, Sr.
Be with them as they walk through this tough time, trusting in you.
Yay, God.
Lord, we ask that you help us understand the needs of others and to act upon those needs, whether it be raising money for countries without access to fresh water, those who are without a home in this winter, or those who need a friend. Stir our hearts to help those who need us, trusting in you.
Yay, God.
Let us pause for a moment of silent prayer. Into your hands we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your abounding mercy. Fill us with your love and guide us with your grace. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Take a moment to share God's peace with one another.
Peace be with you.
Having passed the peace, we invite you to pass our fellowship pads. They're located in the center of each of our pews. We continue with some of our announcements for today. As was already noted, today is our Unity Worship. Immediately following worship, we'll have our congregational meeting. We do this twice a year, once in the summer, to look at finances, and at this time of the year, to look at governance and leadership, give thanks for the previous year, and look forward to this year that is coming. And we hope that you will stay and support those leaders who will be elected today to our boards, as well as our congregational council, as well as hear an update from our strategic planning team. So please join us after worship for the congregational meeting. For those families that are staying and the children seeing the Vacation Bible School preview during the congregational meeting, that will be happening down in the fellowship hall. Please note, next week our Jazz Vespers returns. It's hard to believe February 12th upon us already, but a wonderful opportunity for fellowship and live music that rivals anything that you will hear in the city. If you haven't been, try it. It is a wonderful worship opportunity and fellowship, Jazz Vespers, next week at 4:30. Please note also our new disciples classes start next week. And as we welcome new folks to this community, we're in need of shepherd sponsors. So if you can help in that way, please see the bulletin for details. Please also see the bulletin for details on our month diaper drive. February is our diaper drive, so this is an empty one, I promise. And we want lots more empty ones, so please see the details how you can support our diaper drive for social ministry. Please also note the details on lunch with the associate pastor, as well as the Fare Requiem. You can get your own score and sing with the mass choir. I'm looking forward to it. I hope you'll join us for that wonderful opportunity. And finally, two more things. This week we used our automated phone calling system for the first time to let the congregation know about a funeral that was held yesterday, a service for Sam, also known as Dick Ellis, who passed away on Wednesday of this week. And in order to get the information out there in time for yesterday's service, we used our email as well as our calling system, recognizing that not everyone is on email. So we hope that word got out. We continue to keep Dolores and the family in our prayers. Finally, this year, 2017, is the 500th anniversary of the Reformation. As a congregation, we're celebrating and commemorating in different ways. And one of the ways we're doing that is sharing our witness as Lutheran Christians. So starting today and periodically over the next months, we'll be hearing from a fellow disciple here at Calvary who answered the question, why are you a Lutheran Christian? So let's listen.
Initially, I was a Lutheran because I was born into a Lutheran family, baptized and confirmed in a Lutheran church. Now, I am still a Lutheran because I believe that we are redeemed by God's bountiful grace through faith in Jesus Christ. Knowing this, I feel free to study God's word, question, and yes, even sometimes doubt my understanding of what this means. Led by the Holy Spirit, I can prayerfully come to a fuller understanding of who Jesus really was and still is, and of how I can be his follower, how I should live my life, and how I can best serve him with and my fellow human beings. My faith helps me to know that, imperfect as I am, my calling is to love God and my neighbors as fully as I am able. Jesus promises to be with me as I attempt to live out that calling. Thanks be to God for the help this Lutheran church gives me in doing that, and for constantly reminding me that even when I falter, I am still cherished by my Creator.
Thank you, Janet. There she is. Yeah. In addition to that project, we also have something called Find Luther Bear. It's going to start next month, so you'll be hearing more about our Luther Bear and how he'll be involved on Sunday morning worship, something for all ages. Let's continue to worship God now with the offering. We ask our second graders to stay, and the rest of the junior choir can return to their seats. Second graders, stay up here so we can lead the Lord's Prayer at the time of communion. Now we come to the Lord's table. Please stand. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. We give God thanks and praise in all seasons of life, especially remembering that in the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people, for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." And now our second graders, if you would lead us in the first line of our Lord's Prayer. Give us this day daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. This is the Lord's table. All are welcome. We'll distribute today at four stations, all of them standing. The ushers will direct you. Please be seated.
In my wrestling and in my doubts, in my failures, you won't walk out. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Whoa. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Questions, your truth will hold. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Whoa. You are the peace in my troubled sea. My lighthouse.
Save to shore.
Now the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. As Calvary's disciples, we will give glory to God. God of glory, dwell in you richly, name you beloved, shine brightly on your path, and the blessing of Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be upon you, remain with you always.
Let's give thanks one more time for all who helped lead us in worship, for all of our choirs, our praise teams, our chancel choir. Can we give a lovely joy lifted up to God for all this wonderful worship? We invite those who are able to stay for our congregational meeting to go ahead and remain in the sanctuary, unless you need a short break. Everyone else, I invite our Sunday school class to dismiss us with our commissioning. If all together on three, our Sunday schoolers will say our commissioning. One, two, three. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thanks to the Lord, our God and King, His love endures forever. Oh, He is good, He is above all things, His love endures forever. Sing praise, sing praise. With a mighty hand and outstretched arm, His love endures forever. The life that's been, it's been reborn. His love endures forever. Sing praise, sing praise, sing praise. Forever God is strong. Forever. alone.